Assalamu alaikum. Hello and welcome to Food Passion with Kulsum. Today I'll be sharing my Shahi chicken korma recipe with you all. This recipe is just amazing. This korma goes so well for a guest. No matter what occasion it is, whether it's some engagement ceremony or just a birthday party or just a get together, your family and your friends are going to just love you for making this. So let's check out what ingredients we'll be needing to make this amazing and delicious chicken Shahi Korma. 500 grams of chicken with bone, 4 large onions thinly sliced, 200 grams of thick yogurt, and whole spices. I'm using 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds, few black peppers, few bay leaves, few cardamom pod, 1 stick of cinnamon, and few cloves, few saffron strands, and a cup of milk, 3 tablespoons of ginger garlic paste, 3 tablespoons of cashew nut bits or whole cashew nuts, 1 tomato sliced, 200 ml of cooking oil, and some fresh coriander for garnishing. Alright, I've heated a large pot to make this korma and I'm adding the oil into it. It's very hot. And to this now I'll add the onions. I'm going to brown the onions. Nice golden color. Well, this is also called barista in India. You have to keep the onions light golden brown, because if you make them too dark or too much brown, your curry or your korma is going to get a bitter taste. So please keep that in mind. By the time my onions are getting brown, what I'm going to do is add the saffron into the milk and just let it be there for some time. Alright, so now as you can see, my onion is light brown. This is when you have to switch off the flame, because the oil is so hot, it's going to make it more brown. So now what I'll do is I'll just remove it out. Okay, onto a plate. Alright, I've removed all the onion from the oil. And you can see some bits remaining, but that's okay. Alright, so now to this I'm going to add the ginger garlic paste. I'm going to add in all the whole spices. And sliced tomato. Let it fry for 5 minutes. After this, I'll add all the spices with the salt. Give it a stir. And to this, I'll add the chicken pieces. Mix it nicely. Put the flame on high. Fry till 5 minutes. Alright, by the time my chicken is frying, what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a paste of the onions and the yogurt and the cashew nut bits. You can use whole cashew nuts, and if you're allergic to cashew nuts, you can use blanched almonds. Just remove the skin and use it. So now I'll add the onions. Alright, now I'm going to make a paste out of this. This is how your onion, cashew nut and the yogurt paste should look like after you grind it. And now I'm going to go ahead and add it to the chicken. Just give it a nice mix. Look at the beautiful color it's got. and the taste is just amazing. You should give it a try, because whenever I make this, my family just does not stop praising me for this. Alright, to this now I'm going to add the saffron milk which I had made. Alright, here you go. It's all rich and thick. If you don't want to use yogurt by any chance, you can go ahead and use fresh cream. Alright, now I'm going to give it a nice mix. So now let it cook for 2 to 3 minutes on high flame, and then we'll put our flame on low. Alright, after 2 minutes we lower the flame. Alright, now I'm going to keep this on low flame for another 10 to 15 minutes. After 10 minutes of cooking on very low flames, it's very thick so it might stick to the bottom. So what I did is just added half a cup of water, and I'm going to allow it again to cook till the chicken is done. After 15 minutes, I'm going to check. And as you can see, the oil has come up, and this is when the gravy is done. So now I'm going to switch off the flame. I'm going to put some fresh coriander. My chicken Shahi Korma is ready. You can serve this with bagala rice or with naan, roti, paratha. It tastes amazing, and I hope you like the recipe. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe to my channel. Do take care of yourself. Until my next video, Allah Hafiz. Bye.